Namaste and welcome to Divine Wellness. I'm Suyash.
And I'm Arshna.
We are here to present you Ardha Chandrasana, the half moon pose. It's also named as crescent moon pose because it resembles the crescent moon in the final position. It's very similar to the crescent moon. Now Arshna is here to help us understand the demonstration. To come in this asana, we have to first assume Ashva Sanchalanasana. So to assume Ashva Sanchalan, please come in the center of your mat, close to the front, with feet together, arms by the side, arms relaxed, hanging by the side of the body, keeping the spine straight. You have to bend from the hips. So lean forward from the hips. With your palms, try to reach down to the floor by the side of the feet. Now, take your right leg back. Now this is Ashva Sanchalanasana. Here, your fore leg is perpendicular to the floor and toes are tucked in. Now, to move into the Ardha Chandrasana, you have to join the palms in Namaskar Mudra and raise the arms up over the head, as simultaneously you arch the lower back, upper back and the neck. This is a perfect crescent moon. You hold for a bit and then with exhalation come out. You do not strain, do not harm yourself, just completely change. Now, keeping the palms on the floor, take support on the floor and change the legs. Okay, now you took the left foot back and right foot is in front. Now again, join the palms in Namaskar Mudra, breathe in and raise the arms over the head, simultaneously arching the back of the neck and shoulders. Perfect. With exhalation, come out. As you have seen, come back again, take your feet back together and rest back in Shashankasana. Take three breaths in and out, relax the back, relax your buttocks, legs, the lower body completely. Relax the shoulders, relax your arms, back of the neck. Now with inhalation, slowly taking support of your palms, lift your body up. Yes, sit up and come out of the practice. Now, as I showed, the relaxation asana should follow this practice because it's a bit strenuous on the back and overall on the lower body also. Ideally, this practice should not be done by people who are having weaker back conditions. Any sort of neck condition, people who have hernia or any kind of injury or surgery in the abdominal or pelvic region. Sciatica and slip disc people should also not attempt this practice. Now, there are a lot of benefits that we take so much pain to do this practice, basically, because it is a very good practice to strengthen the shoulders and back. It's a very good practice to tone the buttocks, thighs and the pelvic floor. So prospective women who are prospective mothers should try this practice before getting into pregnancy thing, and should consult their yoga instructor for guidance before their first trimester, and should not attempt later on. And as I say always, to consult your expert for practices, please log on to www.divinewellness.com. We are the first in the world to offer live and interactive yoga classes. Stay healthy, stay safe. Namaste.